Now, Director Cadle, would you agree that this is the most serious security lapse since President Reagan was shot in 1981 of the Secret Service?
Yes, sir, I would.
And, you know, do you know what Stuart Knight did when he was in charge at the time of the Secret Service? Do you know what he did afterwards?
He remained on duty.
He resigned. He resigned. And Stuart Knight was not a Democratic appointee or a Republican appointee. Look, I'm not questioning your judgment.
I can't believe I'm saying these words. But he's right. I mean, that's actually correct. He's a Democrat. He's endorsed Kamala Harris as the nominee. But he's also said, yeah, you should. I mean, he didn't come right out and tell Cheadle, you need to go. But he's like, you know what the last guy did who screwed up? He went. So he's not wrong. Welcome back to the program. Top of the second hour. Dana Loesch with you. And a lot to get into. I mean, this is just the hearing with the Secret Service, the head of the Secret Service, Kimberly Cheadle. The ongoing, I mean, the stuff that's coming out about the Secret Service and the other developments about this attempted assassination. A lot. And then, of course, you have Biden out and then living in chaos on Rumble. Actually gave us a Rumble rant, and it's actually funny. And he said, how many presidential aides does it take to change a light bulb? None. They're supposed to keep him in the dark. That's actually true. It's like the one job that you don't do your job. Exactly. That's your job. What's your job? You don't do it. Oh, God. So thank you very much. Very awesome. I'm still like, I need a screen up, like another one. Yeah, I got this big giant one here, but I need another one like right here so I can see everything, like stock, you know, the stocks and all that. I don't know. All right, let's get into it because, I'm telling you, I don't think Biden's got COVID. I'm just going to say it. I don't think he has COVID at all. I think that that's an excuse for him to be frittered away in his beach house if he's okay. I don't even know. Is he awake? Is he aware? Kane is wrapping him. Okay, so there's not enough tinfoil in the world to get us to where Kane is right now. Let me just say that. I think that he's just holed up at his beach house. I don't think he has COVID at all whatsoever. Because I thought here's why I don't think he had ever had COVID. Do you remember the story of the lawmaker that they said had COVID and was around Biden? A couple of weeks before he was at that Vegas event. And I thought, oh, man, they're going to be testing him 6 ways to Sunday. And then they immediately, quarantine him or whatever. They wouldn't, if they thought Biden had it, they wouldn't have had him out shaking everybody's hands and doing all this stuff. You know, he's coughing because he's old and probably dying. Let's just be honest about it. What I don't get into, can I just do this as a sidebar? I'm just saying this in advance of anything with Jimmy Carter. I know my grandparents and my mother used to have this saying. Well, my mother still kind of does. My grandmother did. And it also applied if you were like old and like almost dead, but not dead, you know, just there and the dead. And, you know, you don't speak ill of the dead, or you only say nice things about someone who's like super old and sick or someone who's dead. And I totally do not subscribe to that at all whatsoever. You know why? Because you're not afforded any kind of courtesy if you were a jackass on this rock. Okay. I'm not going to sit here. Oh, well, bygones. Nope. And I'm not holding a grudge. I'm just not going to sugarcoat your nastiness. For what? Just because what you did something that millions and billions of other people throughout the annals of human history have done, you've gotten old and died. I'm not going to sit here and not say anything mean about you or acknowledge the fact that you were an absolute jackwagon when you were alive on Earth just because somehow you getting old and sick. That doesn't invalidate any of that. No, I'm not doing any of it. No. I think that's pretty fair, Kane.
I said so.
Yeah. Because I see the press is already like, oh, President Biden, such a heroic. What? For real? Oh, yes, Joe Biden, you know, so can you believe it? He's such a... Oh, and then they're getting ready. You are getting ready to see a media fluffing like you have... Don't Google it. That you have never, ever seen in your life. Give me a better way to describe it, Kane. Because all I can think of are these headlines right now in front of me.
Boot lick? Butt kiss?
Yeah.
Okay.
That. They are going to try to create... They're going to try to Photoshop the reality of Kamala Harris. Airbrush, Photoshop, Facetune, whatever. They're going to try to do that. They're going to try to put all the filters over Kamala Harris. Imagine that one friend that has bad skin, and you know everybody's got one of them friends, right? You know, they just were on the struggle bus through their youth. You know, maybe the Accutane wasn't enough. I don't know. And, you know, they filter themselves to where they literally look like marzipan. You know what that is? The almond paste that you put over baked goods. Nobody looks like that in real life. They look like a damn character from Wallace and Gromit because they're so filtered out, right? And you look at their pictures on Insta or Facebook and you're like, chick, I know that you have age spots. What are you doing? Anyway, they're trying to do that to her whole record. They're going to do that to Kamala Harris's record, right? Here's the first headline. It's coming from everybody. A guide to the coming attacks on Kamala Harris. I'm sorry, what? Yes, it's a guide to the coming attacks on Kamala Harris.
The coming?
You mean like acknowledging her record and like being maybe kind of critical of it? The Kamala Harris juggernaut. Oh boy. It's going to get so bad, isn't it? It's going to get so dumb. It's going to get so stupid. Yeah, it is. So, celebrate America's founding principles of God-given natural rights, liberty, and limited government with Hillsdale College. And thanks to the team at Hillsdale College, you can watch an inspiring portrayal of Thomas Jefferson reflecting on the Declaration of Independence in a letter that he wrote late in his life. Watch the inspiring video on Thomas Jefferson's letter about the Declaration of Independence written on its 50th anniversary. Amidst the far left's rejection of liberty and equality, let's reaffirm these principles as America's source of greatness, a treasure to preserve. Join me in reminding ourselves and our children and our fellow citizens about the blessings of liberty. Since its founding in 1844, Hillsdale College has stayed true to its mission of providing the education necessary to safeguard principles rooted in the Declaration signed on July 4th. Visit Dana4Hillsdale.com to view this video and receive a free commemorative copy of the Declaration from Hillsdale as our thanks. Keep it or pass it on. Visit Dana4Hillsdale.com. And on behalf of Hillsdale College, let us always treasure America's independence. They're saying Trump world is really mad that Biden is no longer running. Good heavens. They're really trying to set it up. Oh, Business Insider. Donald Trump is now the oldest party nominee for president in U.S. history. I mean, it was Joe Biden. Oh my. Hey, you know what? But he doesn't fall down on flat surfaces. Amazing that, right? I don't know. They're going to do this instead of answering the question, why did you carry the water for this lie? They're going to sit here and they're going to try to strawman her up into something that she is not. And you're going to see the media work to help her in ways that you have never, it is going to be a coordinated PR effort that you have never, the likes of which you have never before seen. It's not even really starting yet. It's just now kind of starting because they don't know really if she's got it yet. So they're kind of waiting. Instead of asking, why did you carry water? The same people that called you a conspiracy theorist for daring to suggest that Biden maybe shouldn't be running for office again because he doesn't look so great or sound so great are now the same people who want you to believe that Kamala Harris is just like a juggernaut, I think was the headline. Oh my God, really? Is that why she wasn't the juggernaut that wasn't officially endorsed by the Obamas, hasn't even been endorsed by Schumer or Pelosi yet, that juggernaut? Okay. No, they are absolutely, they're not going to ask any of those questions. The media is not there to ask questions. The media is there to try to get power. They are just a wing of the Democrat Party at this point. Well, not, they are. They absolutely are. They're just there to get a Democrat elected. They're not there to ask questions. I mean, good grief. You had, what's her face? The lady who doesn't know the difference between the Nordstrom pipeline and the Nord Stream pipeline. Yeah, Nordstrom. I want a Nordstrom pipeline. I mean, those sales. I mean, come on, right up and put it right up in my closet. Let's get her done. How did she say emeritus?
Emeritus.
Jeez. Yeah, tyranny.
Yeah,
There's a whole bunch of stuff that she is just not. Oh, and then instead of saying deep fake, she said cheap fake. She's not an old lady, but she has like an old lady way of messing up stuff with that she says. And you guys know it. I had a great aunt that would guarantee mess up any name that you gave her. It was actually kind of funny. You think Starbucks is bad with the names on the cups? It was like my great aunt conceived that whole thing. So they're not going to ask about any of that. They played all of their voters for suckers. And their voters are like, oh, can I have some more, please? Democrats treated their voters like actual excrement. And the voters are like, yeah, that sounds right. Woohoo! Now we're off for Harris. You literally just got robbed. You went to the primaries and caucuses and you picked a dude. And now the party's like, nope. And you're not going to be able to vote for this nominee. This is an election in which the Democrat voters are literally not going to be able to select their own nominee. It's going to be the party insiders, just the way the party wants it. And then these people are the ones who have the audacity to sit here and go, our democracy's under threat. Do you even know what that is? Our democracy's under threat. You didn't even get to pick your character. Our democracy's under threat. Or your candidate. Good night. It's a cheap fake. How dare you criticize the man who's falling down on flat surfaces and thinking dead people are talking to him? How dare you? That's a cheap fake. What? That's what they said. Anytime. Remember, anytime. The only reason, and they go, oh, Trump's a felon. The only reason Biden's not a felon is because they literally said that he was too old and senile to go to court. But he's apparently not old or senile enough to run the country. I don't know, man. I don't know. This is wild. But that's, yeah, the Democrat voters got played for absolute suckers. And then they're going to go out there and bitch and moan about democracy. You're not even getting to pick your own candidate. You're suckers. You got played again, like you got played in 2016. You got played. You got played again in 2020, but 2016, it was a little, they messed up. They showed you their hand a little bit. They weren't as surreptitious about it as they thought they were being. And now they're just doing it right out in the open. Well, that's okay. Yes, we all know that you voted for this guy, except you, maybe Ohio. We all voted for this guy, but now we're just going to put somebody else there. And the only reason that that even happened is because he just foobarred the whole debate. Yeah, so all Democrats got played like suckers, and they're going to sit here and act like they're the party of the people. Oh, no, they don't just have delegates. They got super delegates. I got delegates with capes. Well, they're super, Kane. What makes them so super? Well, they're not regular people. You know, they're not stupid, regular, unwashed people. They're Democrat governors and senators and big donors. So they're it's a bunch of nepotism. Yes. It's literally a system that's defined by nepotism. And then they go, our democracy's under threat. Absolute clown car. It is an absolute clown car. They need to replace the jackass with a giant clown. Actually, just it. Just have it. Yeah. The clown from Stephen King. You know, the story where he got real bored at the very end and was like, ah, screw it, a spider. That. Make it. That's their new party mascot. The donkey's too good. It's too good. At least it serves a purpose. You know, it works. It's a common animal. Thanks for watching The Dana Show. Make sure to like, subscribe, ring the bell, and stay tuned for more content.